Hi everyone, Janie here. Welcome back to my garden. It is a beautiful, hot day today. It is about 87 degrees and it's supposed to be in the 90s all week. So very, very warm for April. And what I need to do is I need to get moving on getting all of my seedlings out of the greenhouse because it's just gonna be too hot for them in there. And I mostly have, I have some vegetables. I have my micro dwarf tomatoes, which is what I'm gonna work on today. And then I also have a lot of dahlias that I need to start planting out, which I'm very excited about. So today I'm gonna work on potting up my tiny tomatoes, my tiny tomato project, which like I said, those are micro dwarf tomatoes. And I had no idea about micro dwarf tomatoes until JollyGarden720 from Instagram. They have a wonderful Instagram channel, check them out. They were talking about growing micro dwarf tomatoes and how neat it was that you could grow all these different varieties in 1 gallon or less size containers. So really small containers, and you basically can grow them on your patio. If you live in an apartment or a townhome and you don't have a lot of space, or a smaller home like I have with not a lot of space and you want to grow a lot of different varieties, this is a perfect way to grow a lot of different tomato varieties and really save on space. So I decided to do my tiny tomato project this year. That's what I'm calling it. And basically I got 11 different varieties of micro dwarf tomatoes to try out. So I will go through each variety that I chose today and I'll talk about it a little bit, but most of my micro dwarf tomatoes, the seeds I got were from the ultimate tomato guy, and that is Curtis from renaissancefarms.org. He is out of Bloomington, Indiana, and he is just the ultimate obsessed tomato guy. It's really, really sweet. He actually also has a YouTube channel and he has over 400 videos on just the different varieties of tomatoes that he grows and produces seeds for. So I will leave a link to his website below and you can order his tomato seeds from there. He has a whole selection of micro dwarf tomatoes that you can choose from. And I think 10 of the 11 I purchased from him. One other one I did purchase from Baker's Creek, and I'll show you that one. So most of my descriptions that I'm gonna be talking about are actually coming from Curtis, the tomato guy. And I encourage you guys, if you want more information, to look on his website. So I started all of these plants from seed and I grew them on inside on a heating mat and grow lights indoors. And then a couple weeks later, I potted them up into these size pots, about 4-inch pots. And I added just regular potting soil and Sure Start, which is a starter fertilizer. You guys probably noticed my glove. I had a pruner's accident last week. And so I'm just protecting the bandage and making sure it stays clean and dry. So that's why I'm wearing one rubber glove today, just in case you were wondering. So when I potted all the seedlings up, again, I put in a pinch of the EB Stone Sure Start and I just take it out of the bag and I put it in this white pail because it's just easier for me to grab the pinch. However, when I was doing that, I decided to do a little non-scientific science experiment where I took two of the varieties, Tom and Tina, Micro Tom and Micro Tina, and I did one of them without Sure Start and one of them with Sure Start, just so that we could see what the effect of a starter fertilizer has on a plant. And one thing I want to remind you guys is we really won't see it too much until I take these starts out of the pot, because a starter fertilizer really helps with root growth. So I'm excited to see the difference between root growth for the one that I used starter fertilizer as compared to the one that I didn't use starter fertilizer. So this one is Micro Tom, and Micro Tom actually only grows 3 inches tall. So it is the smallest micro dwarf variety there is, but it still produces really well. I have my notes here, that's why I'm looking down here. So it's quick to bloom and fruit, 65 days, deep red fruits with a burst of tang, and it's half to 3/4 gallon containers work well. I'm gonna hold it up where the soil level is. It's about right here is equal soil level, you guys can see there. And the one in my left, my gloved hand, is the one that I did use the starter fertilizer, and the one in the right is the one that I didn't. And you can see that the one in the left actually already has blooms. I think the biggest difference though is actually the leaf color, and I'm not sure if you guys can actually see that on film, but the one on my left hand with the starter fertilizer has a deeper green color leaf, and so I'm really excited to get these guys out of the pots so I can look at the root system and see what the starter fertilizer did to the root system. with Microtina, another variety. This variety is a mix between Microtom and a sugar tomato, is what Curtis says on his website. And this one grows to 8 inches tall, as opposed to Microtom that's 3 inches tall. Tina will grow to 8 inches tall. Smaller size cherry fruits, and again, 3/4 to 1 gallon containers. So I'm gonna hold her soil level equal. And actually the one, they're about the same size plants, but the one on my right is the no starter fertilizer. The one on my left is the starter fertilizer. The biggest difference with Tina, again, is the leaf color. The one that I did use starter fertilizer has a lot deeper green leaves. I hope you guys can see that on film because it's pretty noticeable here. Again, I'll wait and see once I take them out of the pots and I'll see what their root system looks like while I'm potting them up into the pots that they're gonna live in for the rest of the season. Okay, so let's get started potting up Tom and Tina. Okay, so for this season, I'm just gonna pot them up in pots about this size. These are 8-inch diameter pots. That's pretty close to a 1 gallon pot, maybe a little bit smaller. And Curtis from Renaissance Farms basically said that all of these guys will be happy in 3/4 to 1 gallon pots. And bigger is not necessary. It's just kind of a waste of soil and a waste of space is what he says, which I thought was really, really interesting. Some of them, he even said that they would do well in a 6-inch pot. So even really small, maybe just a little bit bigger than this guy, and you would still get fruit from the tomato. So I just think this micro dwarf variety is really, really neat. And it's a, if you're short on space, this is a really cool way to get a lot of different varieties of tomatoes. Okay, so let's start with Tom. So Tom is here. So the one in my gloved hand is the one that got a starter fertilizer, and the one in my right hand is the one that didn't get a starter fertilizer. So I'm gonna take them out so that you guys can see the root system. So for this one, you can see the roots are already coming down to the bottom and they're already coming out a little bit. And then the no starter fertilizer, same thing, looks good too. So it looks to me like the starter fertilizer really just fed the plant. They both seem to have pretty similar root systems, but again, the one that did get the starter fertilizer, at least in Tom's case, he's already blooming and he has a lot deeper green leaves. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna plant the one that I use the starter fertilizer in. But this one still looks healthy too. So if you guys decide not to use the starter fertilizer, I think it's totally fine. You might just wait a little bit longer. Okay, so label, just so I don't lose track of all these guys. I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna mix in some Osmocote just to have some slow release fertilizer in these pots. I think the tomatoes will like that. So let me go grab it really fast. Okay, I got this. This is just a slow release fertilizer that releases when it gets hot. So I think that will be perfect for these tomato plants. So I'm just gonna sprinkle a little bit in the first couple inches and mix it in. And then go ahead and plant the plant. Okay, and there's Tom. Okay, so now let's take a look at Tina. In my left hand is Tina that did get the starter fertilizer. In my right hand is Tina that did not. Again, this is a very non-scientific science experiment and it's just for fun just to see the difference. So let's see the root system on these. All right, so this is, it did get the fertilizer, right? Yes. Okay, so good root system, looking nice and pretty. And then this one did not get the fertilizer. Good root system. Okay, so that's pretty, you know, eye-opening. It helped a little bit, but it's definitely not necessary. You know, they both, the root systems look just as good equally. I would say the only difference I see is the leaf color. So obviously it gave it a little bit more nitrogen. All right, and there's Tina. Okay, 9 more to go. So this one is called Ink Spot, and this one's probably one of the tallest ones of the micro dwarfs that I got. It grows about 12 to 15 inches tall, but it can grow in as small as a 6-inch pot. So it's very small and tall. It has, let's see, it has dark cherry tomatoes, and then it grows in 1 gallon containers is what Curtis recommends. Okay, my next one is Hardin's Miniature. It is a 10 to 12 inch plant, and it produces 1 to 1.5 inch elongated red fruits. It says it'll be ready in 65 days, and most of these will be ready in about 65, 70 days. So probably sometime in June, they'll be ready. And again, 1 gallon containers. Okay, we have Yellow Canary Micro Dwarf Tomatoes. It's described as a beautiful yellow cherry tomato, 8 inches tall, ready in 70 days. And again, 3/4 to 1 gallon pots is good. And Curtis says these are good salad or snacking tomatoes. A lot of these are good salad or snacking tomatoes, which is how I think that's how we're gonna eat most of them. Okay, and then we have Bonsai, which is described as a huge producer of nice fat red cherry tomatoes. It gets 8 inches tall, and the tomatoes are on the sweeter side, he says. I'm making a mess. Okay, then we have Pygmy, which Curtis says is probably the highest producing of the tomatoes that he grows. It's a 7-inch plant, and he says that there are huge clusters of red cherry tomatoes on the plant. He describes them as more tangy than they are sweet, and at 65-day, 3/4 to 1 gallon container. Okay, then we have Fat Frog, which is actually a green tomato. And Curtis says that these plants actually produce some of the largest micro dwarf varieties. So it'll be of the micro dwarf varieties. So it will be interesting to see big tomatoes on a tiny, tiny plant. The plant's only gonna get 10 to 14 inches tall. Okay, then we have Pinocchio, which is a yellow to kind of orangey tomato. It's only a 7-inch tall plant, and it'll be ready in 70 days. Okay, so two more. Orange Hat I actually got from Baker's Creek Seeds. Curtis at Renaissance Farms was out of Orange Hat, and I really wanted to try Orange Hat. I don't know if he got it back now, but when I was purchasing it, he was all out. So good root system. Orange Hat is 6 to 9 inches, but it says it is wildly prolific, which is pretty cool. I feel like Orange Hat is a very common micro dwarf tomato, and a lot of people grow that kind. So you guys might have already heard of the Orange Hat tomato. And then finally, the last one I have is a name I don't know how to pronounce, and it's Monatka. Curtis describes Monatka as one of the best tasting micro dwarf varieties that he sells, which I think is pretty cool. It's heavily producing with fruit that are sweet and flavorful yellow, 8 inches tall, 65 days. And then Curtis, what he recommended, and I didn't do this, which I kind of wish I did, I didn't look at it. He recommends planting them 2 weeks apart, kind of like succession planting. So he says that you can have Monatka plants producing tomatoes all season long. I only have this one, so obviously they're only gonna produce, in a window, but we can enjoy it when they are producing. And I'm sure I'll have plenty of tomatoes here. Okay, you guys, so these are my micro dwarf tomatoes for this year for my tiny tomato project. I'm really excited about the project, and I wanna thank Joy and Holly from Jolly Garden 720 for inspiring us to do stuff like this. They are really, really awesome at growing vegetables, and it's a fun Instagram account to check out. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get these watered in, and then I will show you guys where I'm gonna put them for the year. guys, I am all done. It is so bright out here. I can barely see the phone. I'm like squinting, so I apologize for that. Hopefully the exposure on this video isn't too bad. But I've got all my micro dwarf tomatoes potted up, watered, and put them where I'm gonna leave them, I think, for most of the year. I was gifted this plant stand from a company called Potey, P-O-T-E-Y, and they sell pots and plant stands and things like that on Amazon, and I will link them below. I'm actually really happy with the plant stand. It's really cute, and it was just absolutely perfect for this project, so I wanted to take them up on that. So thank you, Potey, for gifting me this, and let me show you guys what I've got going on. And I will say, I did put an umbrella up just because I can't see anything. It is so bright today. So these are in full sun, but it's gonna look like it's in shade right now because of the umbrella. Okay, here they are. They are close to my vegetable garden, and I just got a shot of a butterfly on my vegetables, so I'll show you guys that really fast. But I wanted them close to the vegetables, in a lot of sun, and this is a south-facing wall, and then I wanted them next to the hose, which is a big thing, because this is gonna be a big watering job this year. And like I said, I think I'm gonna attach them to drip because, you know, we are gonna go, obviously, like visit my mom or go on vacation or stuff like that. So I wanted to make sure that they weren't going to suffer if I wasn't here. So you can see the plant stand is from Potey. It's really cute. It's like a distressed white, and I think it'll be really sweet. And I just, you know, when I saw that, I thought, oh my goodness, that's perfect for this project. You can see I overbought. I got way too many varieties, but there was way too many cool varieties to choose from. And so I think they're kind of cute all lined up like that. So I did put ink spot on the top, which is going to be the tallest one. And then Hardin's miniature is also going to be a tall one, so I put that one there. I did put Micro Tom right here under the shelf because Micro Tom is only going to get 3 inches tall, so that's going to be completely fine under the shelf. And I probably could have shoved one right there, but I liked having 5 down here, so I thought that was pretty. So then we have Fat Frog, Micro Tina, let's see which one's this one, Orange Hat, Pinocchio, Yellow Canary, Bonsai, and finally Pygmy. So yeah, that is it for my tiny tomato project. I will keep you guys updated. I'm thinking in about, I don't know, maybe about early June is when they will really start producing. So I'll be excited to see that. I will be fertilizing these guys, you know, on a regular basis. And I have the Neptune's Harvest, and that's the seaweed and fish fertilizer. And I do have to tell you guys, there's a garbage truck coming, so ignore that. But I made a huge mistake. I used that Neptune's Harvest seaweed and fish fertilizer in my greenhouse the other day. Oh my goodness, it stunk so bad. I mean, literally, I thought all the cats in the neighborhood were gonna be coming into my greenhouse. So I was just wondering if any of you guys had done that, used the fish fertilizer in the greenhouse, because it was nasty. I'm sure all my plants were happy, but no thanks. I don't think I'll be doing that again. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. If you did, please consider subscribing, and I hope you all have a chance to get into your garden today.